What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying Windows 10 2082 within MDT. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is log into your Microsoft Volume License portal. We need to locate our Windows 10 version 2082. We're going to click on that download link. It's going to start downloading the ISO. Once it's done, I'm going to click on that nice little arrow, and I'm going to click on Show in Folder, and it's going to open up the Downloads folder. Now, within my environment, I am running my MDT within Hyper-V. So I'm going to double click on it, get inside my environment, and the first thing that we need to do is make sure that you are running the latest and greatest Windows ADK as well as the Windows PE. Now, if you go inside Control Panel, I am running the latest one, which supports Windows 10 2004, and that Windows ADK 2004 does support 2082. So we are going to open up our MDT workbench, and from here I'm going to go inside the operating system node. I'm going to right click on it and then click on new folder. Now within here I am going to call this folder Windows 10 V2082. Click next, and finish. Done. How easy is that, right? Now the ISO is already mounted within the Hyper-V virtual machine. Hopefully you guys know how to mount an ISO file inside a virtual machine. Now on this folder, I'm going to right click on it and pick Import Operating System. I'm going to leave the default as Full Set of Source Files. Click Next, and I'm going to click on Browse, and I'm going to browse where, you know, the ISO is mounted. By default, it is going to mount it to the D drive. So I'm going to pick the D drive, click OK, click Next here. Now for the destination directory name, you are able to leave it as is, but you are able to change it to whatever you want. Once you're done with that, click on Next. A nice little summary, click on Next, and then it's going to start copying all those files locally to your MDT server. Now, once it's done, you're going to get a confirmation, and then just click on Finish. Now, next thing that we need to do is create our task sequence. So let's go inside a task sequence node. We are going to right click on it and then click on New Task Sequence and give it a sequence ID, a task sequence name. This is really up to you, but this is what I provided within my environment. And then I'm going to click on Next. Now, by default, it gives you the template that you need, and I'm gonna leave it as is and click on Next. And then it's time for us to pick our operating system. Now, I did the SCCM version of this video and I picked the wrong operating system, but I redeemed myself with another video and I fixed it. But for this video, I'm going to pick the correct one. So I created a folder called Windows 10 V2082. So I'm going to open up that folder and I'm going to pick my Windows 10 flavor, which is this one, and then click on Next, and then specify a product key. Once you're done with that, click Next there, and then for the OS settings, configure it to your liking. And then Next, provide an admin password and make sure you confirm it. Next again, a nice little summary, Next, and done. Pretty quick, pretty simple, and then click on Finish. Now, next thing that I like to do within my environment is the primary MDT deployment share node. I like to select it, right click on it, and then just pick Update Deployment Share. You're going to get this nice Update Deployment Share wizard. Click on Next. Next again, and it's going to start cleaning it up and updating it. And once you're done, you're going to get this. Now, don't go anywhere. Right now, you're going to see a fast video of this task sequence being demoed. And that's it. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Smash that subscribe button. And do not forget about hitting that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out. Hey, don't go anywhere. Watch the demo. All right? Later.